Hare Krishna. Namaum Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Itinamine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschata Desha Tarine Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Hare Krishna. Today we are going to discuss the secret of happiness. We all know about the famous story of the Mahabharata, and we are familiar with some of the characters of Mahabharata. The main groups in Mahabharata is the Kauravas and the Pandavas. Now, in Kauravas, they were always unhappy, although they ruled for a very long period, almost 100 years. They were able to rule by different means, but they were always unhappy. But on the other side, the Pandavas, they were always in problems, but they were always in peace and happiness. So, what is the reason why Pandavas, with all the miseries, all the distress, all these unhealthy living places, they were happy, and why Kauravas, especially Duryodhan and Dushasan, they were living in palaces, but still they were not having peace and happiness within inside. So what is the reason? What makes people happy? From where they get peace? What are the main causes? When Lord Krishna shared the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita with Arjun, that time in the second chapter we find in the shloka number 66, Lord says, Nastir buddhi yuktasya nacha yuktasya bhavana nacha bhavayatah shantir ashantasya kutah sukham. That means Lord says, one who is not connected with the supreme in Krishna consciousness can have neither transcendental intelligence nor a steady mind, and without which there is no possibility of peace, and how can there be any happiness without peace? Let us understand this shloka by understanding meaning of each and every words of this shloka or the message of this shloka. So here Lord explains about the subtle body, how the subtle body of any individual person operates. So let us understand. See, we can see this gross body, which is made of 5 gross elements: earth, water, fire, air and ether. And this gross body is either buried or burned after death. So this is just like an hardware. This hardware is operated by the software which is inside this gross body, and that software is called subtle body. And this subtle body is made of 3 important elements. In these 3 elements, mind is the lowest element. Above mind we find intelligence, and above intelligence is the ego. That means the identification. Ego means identification, how I identify myself as. See, from the teachings of Bhagavad Gita, we understand that we are not this body, we are soul. So whenever we consider ourselves as body, that is our false identification, wrong identification. That is called false ego. But when we consider ourselves as soul, that is our true identification. That is our true identification, but we always believe ourselves in our false identification, that we consider ourselves as body only. But the true identification, the true ego, is we are soul. Now let us understand systematically, when we are in the false identification, false ego, considering ourselves as a body, and parallelly when we are in true identification, considering ourselves as soul. So what are the differences? How the things progress? How the software operates? One more thing we should understand from the Bhagavad Gita only, from the 15th chapter, 7th number slok, Lord says, Mamai vanse jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana. What does it mean? See, many people understand that I am soul. But what is soul? That is explained in this shloka. The soul is part and parcel of Supreme Lord. And what does it mean? What is the job of any part from a big machine or from the whole universe or from the entire creation? The main job, the main role of the part is to serve the whole, to do its duty. So with this we understand that soul is part and parcel of the Supreme Lord, and its activity is to serve the Lord. That means to cooperate with Lord in his activities. But whenever we are in our false identification, false ego, instead of understanding myself as cooperator, I start understanding myself, start believing myself as the owner. This is purely because of our false identification. We identify ourselves with body and we consider ourselves the owner of this body, and the ultimate goal with that identification becomes to satisfy the senses or the needs of this body. So now let us understand, one side, in our true ego, true identification, we consider ourselves as soul. That means we are considering ourselves as cooperator, but here we are considering ourselves as owner. Now the cooperator is always happy by doing his duties. Once we are completed, we completed our duties, we are happy. But here the owner, he can never become happy, because he thinks something, that this if I will achieve, I will be happy. But the moment he achieves that thing, more greed props up. And now he has got multiple goals and he want to own those things. And now let us understand, come down in the software. We are considering ourselves as body and as soul. But here, once we start considering ourselves as body, we consider ourselves as owner, not as a cooperator. And then because of this, the intelligence, the second element of the subtle body, which is called intelligence, it has got some activities. And the main activities of the intelligence is, first, to differentiate, second, to take decision, and the third is to be determined on whatever decision we have taken. Now, because I am considering myself as owner, enjoyer, but we are not owner and enjoyer, we are cooperator, but because of our false identification, we consider ourselves as owner and enjoyer, and that's why the intelligence is now doing differentiation, taking decision, and it is determined on this identification. And the lowest element in the subtle body is mind. And what is mind? Mind is storehouse of our previous memories. And what type of memories? Two types of memories. One is fulfilled and unfulfilled desires, and second, pleasant and unpleasant feelings. So mind is storehouse of these two types of memories. And with these memories, mind whenever come in contact with the sense objects, that time it starts willing to enjoy, to get good feeling. All unfulfilled desires, now it want to fulfill the moment it comes in contact with the sense objects. So, the feeling is the first activity of the mind. Second activity of the mind is thinking. How he can achieve those sense objects so he can fulfill his desires. And then, whenever he is trying to fulfill his desire or he is getting some reactions, he gets some feeling. So, these are the three activities of mind: willing, thinking and feeling. But this mind works when intelligence has taken the decision and if it is determined. So, mind is actually works under intelligence guidance, and this mind gives command to this gross body. Now, this gross body has got 5 working senses and 5 knowledge acquiring senses. So, actually this is the vehicle, and the mind is now controlling this gross body vehicle. But mind is controlled by intelligence, and intelligence does all its activities based on the identification. But here on the other side, when we are in our true identification, we identify ourselves as cooperator. The moment we understand ourselves as a cooperator, the first thing comes is contentedness. Contentedness is the very important factor here. In our false identification, we can never be contented because there are unlimited sense objects. So, there are unlimited desires and unlimited ways of fulfilling those desires. So, one can never be contented in the false identification. But in our true identification, when we consider ourselves as soul, that means part and parcel of the Supreme Lord, that means cooperator, and we are contented by doing our duties, that means cooperating with the Lord. And this contentedness gives us the best and the most important thing, what Lord Krishna explains in this shloka. Nasti buddhir yuktasya. The moment you are in that identification, true identification, in the Krishna consciousness identification, that we are part and parcel of the Lord and we are servant of the Supreme Lord, our intelligence is purified. And when intelligence is purified, the mind is peaceful. And when mind is peaceful, you will always get happiness. But our problem is, instead of considering Lord Krishna as a Supreme Lord, although he has claimed this in the 5th chapter, 29 number slok, Bhoktaram Yajna Tapsam Sarvaloka Maheshwaram, he is the ultimate enjoyer of all the yajnas, and he is the owner of all the planets, all the universes. He claims directly that he is the owner. But instead of accepting that guidance, instructions, we consider ourselves as owner. Now, how many things or up to what extent can we own? The ant also tries to own certain area, few activities. Same way, the dog, the cat, everybody wants to have control over some area. Same way, we humans, we consider few things and we try to understand ourselves owner of these places, these activities, our possessions, our family members. We consider ourselves as owner. But ultimately, why all these thoughts are coming? Because we are not identifying ourselves properly. Under our false identification, we identify ourselves as owner of these material things. And without understanding ourselves, without remaining in proper identification with this false identification, we are always struggling to achieve more and more sense objects so that we can satisfy our senses. Now let us see, for so many lifetimes we have been satisfying our senses, but these senses, specifically the mind, is never satisfied. What is the reason? The only reason is we are in false identification. We are considering ourselves as body. That's why we consider ourselves as owner or the proprietor. But ultimately, what is our possession? We are not owner. We are cooperator. Cooperator. And whom we are cooperating? The ultimate owner of this entire universe. And he is the ultimate supreme enjoyer. So we just need to cooperate him. The moment we come under this identification understanding, the best thing happens to us. We become contented. And this contentedness purifies our intelligence. This is what Lord Krishna says. Until and unless our identification is not in Krishna consciousness, our intelligence will not be purified. And when intelligence is not purified, the mind is not steady and peaceful. And when mind is not steady and peaceful, there is no chance, no question of happiness. And this we have experienced with many, many pastimes of Lord Krishna. We have seen in his Bal Leela, the Kansa, he was also remembering Lord. Every moment he was remembering Lord, but in a totally different sense. He was considering himself as owner, proprietor of his kingdom, and he always wanted to enjoy. And he was considering Krishna as his enemy because of the Akashvani. He was always considering Krishna as the instrument or the person who is going to be the reason for his death. And because of that reason, he had fear that one day Krishna will come and he will kill him. He did not wanted to die. He wanted to remain as a owner and enjoyer. He was also remembering Krishna, but not in proper understanding. That's why he was fearful. He was always in distress, always unhappy. And he tried all his strength and power to kill Krishna when he was a small child, but he was never successful, and ultimately he left the body. He had to die. But same way, if we parallelly see the Gwalbalas, the gopis, they were always happy with Krishna. They are always helping Krishna in doing his activity. We have seen in the Govardhan Leela, when Krishna lifted entire Govardhan with his little finger, all the other Gwalbalas, gopis, they were trying to help Krishna with their sticks. Same way we have seen gopis and the other Gwalbalas in Vrindavan, all their activities were centered to please Krishna. So they were always happy, immaterial of the outer situation. So this way, in Braj Leela, there we understood that those who were considering Krishna as a Supreme Lord, they were always happy. But other way, whoever do not consider Krishna or Lord as a supreme owner or the enjoyer, and he wants to enjoy separately, independently from the Lord, they will always be in suffering. So we understand with this discussion, specifically from this few shlokas of Bhagavad Gita, second chapter, 66th number shloka, Nasti Buddhir Yuktasya, and from fifth chapter, 29 number shloka, Bhuktaram Yajnatapsam Sarvaloka Maheshwaram, and the 15th chapter, 7 number shloka, Mamayavanse Jeev Loke, Jeev Bhuta Sanatana. If we understand these three shlokas properly, we will get the real secret of happiness, the real secret of peace. If you really want to be in peace, you should come on the platform of true ego, true identification. We are not this body, we are soul. And soul is part and parcel of the Supreme Lord. And the main activity of the soul is to cooperate with the Lord, serve the Lord in doing His own activities. The moment we are in that identification, we will be contented. Here in the false identification, we can never be contented whatsoever we get from this material world. So, with this, we would like to summarize our discussion that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We don't know about His position, we don't know about His strength, qualities. So, we should get this knowledge from Bhagavad Gita or with the Vaishnavas who has realized this knowledge. We should approach them, ask them, surrender them and try to take guidance from them. Then only we will come to a position in our real true identification. Otherwise, in this material world, we are bombarded with this advertisement industry, with advertisement in each and every second, at each and every place. We are forced to, we are exposed to so many advertisements which are directly telling us, come and fulfill your senses, enjoy your senses. The objects of sense gratification is here and you can do it. If you don't have money, we are ready to provide you all these objects of sense gratification on credit card or loan facility. But the moment we try to get all those things, we try to enjoy our senses with these objects, new set of problems arises. And this trap keeps on increasing. And ultimately, we never find happiness in this material world. The real happiness is only possible when we are in our true identification. We are serving as much as possible to Lord with this pure and true identification. So ultimately, the secret of happiness is to be in our true identification, that we are part and parcel of the Lord. Our main activity is to serve the Lord, and we are always cooperator, not the owner. Once we are in that bhava, in that mood that I am cooperator, we are contented after doing our seva, our services. And this gives us happiness because our intelligence is purified, mind is in peace and body is in happiness. Hare Krishna.